If you have access to lemons or salt, you know, basic stuff, then it would really be a shame if you aren't making this. Trust me. So these preserved lemons are a North African condiment that can be used in many, many ways, even beyond North African slash Moroccan cuisine. Now, like I said, it's literally just salt and lemons left to ferment for a few weeks. That's it. It's not rocket science. And to be honest, I hate seeing people waste money on buying jars of preserved lemon for like $16 for like two lemons. That's a no good. We're gonna make them, and you're gonna see and understand.
Now, this recipe is very straightforward, so it's gonna go by pretty quickly. So you're gonna start with 10 to 12 Meyer lemons. Now, if you can't find Meyer lemons, then regular lemons are totally fine. Just try to make sure that these are organic because, you know, the skin here is kind of our point of interest and you're gonna be eating mostly that, so, you know. Nip off just a tiny bit of both ends of each lemon. The cut should be deep enough to reveal only pith and no yellow flesh, so you know you're not... Oh, and don't do that, because, you know, that happens. Don't drop your lemons, because that's not good. If you drop your lemons, make sure to wash them off, because that's good. That's... And I didn't wash it off, did I? Nope. All right. Well, don't do that, please. Now, once you've nipped the ends off of each lemon, you're going to take a lemon and cut it in half lengthwise, but wait, you're going to stop before you cut all the way through. That way, two pieces are still held together with a little nub on the bottom. Rotate that piece 90 degrees and repeat that so you now have a quarter lemon with all quarters still attached with about a quarter inch nub at the bottom. And repeat that with all lemons. Now, for the record, I actually did wash all my lemons after that. That was mainly just a joke. Please make sure that you do wash your produce when doing any sort of fermentation. It can be really dangerous if you don't wash it. So this sounds so fake right now, but I swear I did wash them after that shot. Okay, so you've got your quartered lemons. Now all you gotta do is take each lemon and place one in a small bowl, gently open up the lemon a bit, and sprinkle extremely generously with salt. Just go ham on that salt. Don't worry about it being too salty. Just do it until you fill that lemon up like you see here. Then just place them into a half-gallon glass container, such as a mason jar. Don't do metal because it reacts with the acidity of the lemons. If you want to add aromatics such as a cinnamon stick or some bay leaves, then feel free to add those now. I kept mine pretty simple, just lemons and salt. Now every two or three lemons added to the jar, just sprinkle a small spoonful of salt into the jar itself as well. Then once all of your lemons are added, you're gonna mash them all into your jar so they release their juice and eventually are all tightly packed together and are covered by the lemon juice. Now if the lemons don't produce enough juice to cover them, then that's no big deal. You can just add a little more lemon juice until, you know, it does. Then just pack them down, simply place a loose lid on top to cover, and leave out at room temperature to ferment and age for 3 to 4 weeks. Now, you're gonna wanna taste them at 3 weeks to see if you wanna leave them out for the full four. It's just up to you. Now, just make sure that during these weeks that you're checking every once in a while that the lemons are submerged under that brine and, you know, just, you know, gently shake it and press them down again. If they're not, no big deal. This is a really chill type of ferment. Oh, and lastly, when your ferment is done, you can just tighten that lid and place it in the fridge, and it'll stay good in the fridge for a very long time. When I say a long time, I mean months. If you see any mold developing, obviously throw them away, but you should be all good to go. Now, let's talk about how you use preserved lemons. So basically, the first thing you're gonna do is remove the flesh. Now, the flesh is super salty, and that's not exactly the prized possession of the preserved lemon. The skin is actually what you want. So, you know, you can save the flesh and use it in stews, stocks, and soups. Now, once you remove the flesh and you have just the skin, you can do a lot with it. You can slice it into threads, you can brunoise it, or you can just blend it into a puree and add it to whatever you want. It's great for dressings and sauces, literally anything. A lot of Moroccan recipes use it as in tagine style recipes like braised Moroccan chicken, which I may post a recipe for later on. You can add it to dips to add lemony citrusy notes. You know, think of something like salsa verde, guacamole, pesto, you know, something like that. You can add a little bit of preserved lemon to it. It's pretty dope. Yeah, you can add it to avocado toast. You know, sorry, not sorry. Toss some roasted root vegetables in them. The possibilities for preserved lemons are truly limitless. Now, go out into the world and show them your preserved lemons.
All right, guys. guys, and that is it. So I hope at this point you're a preserved lemon fan now, right? No? This was a pretty straightforward one, so I'll leave you with this. If you enjoyed this video or you learned something, leave a like, subscribe, and I will see you next week.